start our Vitra building.
Okay, this is the masters. Okay.
Yeah, that's masters.
Right. As I said, initially the goal was to clear FSP and KP exam. Once these two exams are cleared, you will get permanent license.
Yes.
And that permanent license is called as approbation.
Approbation.
Right? Clearing FSP and immediately clearing KP is not that easy.
Mm.
Okay. The point is, even if you're ready, system is not ready. Everything takes time. Be ready to have more patience in the whole process of this. Some of the students here in Germany are waiting for I don't know how many months, even after submitting documents for at Lageso.
Yes.
In this case, you've been waiting for what?
I have been waiting since last 4 months.
Just to get an acknowledgement, right?
Mm.
So the whole process takes a lot of time. Have more patience if you really want this whole thing. Trust me, at the end of everything, it's going to be fruitful. It's going to be really, really awesome. When you clear your FSP exam, you get a Beruf's Erlaubnis, which is the temporary license by which you can already start working as a doctor. But as he said, those work experience will not be counted as an official work experience in Germany because you don't have a permanent license. Beruf's Erlaubnis is a temporary license. Now, to get a permanent license, you need to clear one more exam which is left, which is Kenntnis Prüfung.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes, Kenntnis Prüfung.
Kenntnis Prüfung.
Medical knowledge examination.
Right, right. And this is why it was important that you take those two courses which he took from India before flying here.
Yeah.
So this is what his journey is like. Now, if you meet 10,000 people, they will tell you 10,000 stories to get approbation as a permanent license. Trust me, but this whole master's studies after MBBS has become a huge business now for consultancies, for third-party providers, or for all those middlemen. One thing which you have to be prepared with is a lot of patience and a lot of money. The way, the path what he chose, it was his way, and I feel that it's still affordable compared to what I've seen, the horror stories, what I've heard from other people, where they had to pay 14,000-15,000 euros just to come here and learn language. A lot of consultancies will also tell you that, hey, you know what, you don't need to do B1, B2 in India. You can just go there and learn right in Germany. I feel that you can save a lot of money with that. You could spend more time in India, learn language, while you're learning language, do more research. Consultancies will tell you like, hey, listen, do only A1 and A2 here, we'll send you there and you'll do everything rest there. That is gonna cost you a lot of money. Apart from that, some consultancies will also push you to take up FSP course and the Kenntnis Prüfung course somewhere random place where it's not even recognized. In fact, you sometimes even have to pay 7,000-8,000 rupees euros for that. For your FSP course and for Kenntnis Prüfung course, how much did you pay?
For FSP course, I paid 2,070 euros.
Mm-hmm.
And for Kenntnis Prüfung, I paid 2,340 euros.
Right, right.
Yeah, but one should book this course before minimum 6 to 8 months. Because
wow.
It is a very, very, very long waiting list to get into such recognized course.
Right.
So you have to prepare yourself at the beginning of the everything.
Right.
Before, right. I guess, for 6 to 8 months.
Right. Again, be aware, these consulting companies would put you anywhere. Okay, there are cheaper courses also. Trust me, there are.
Hmm.
But they are not recognized. Who can they write the email to?
Ausländer Behörde.
Okay, so foreign office.
For an immigration office that it is recognized or not.
Okay, so in India only you can write an email to a foreign office who, you know, consulate there or an embassy. Ask them, this is the place where they're offering me this and this course. Is this recognized or not? They are the right people to give you visa when you're preparing everything from India.
Once you have your Beruf's Erlaubnis, you can work as an official doctor in Germany, but this won't be counted in your Weiterbildung. For example, if you need to perform 500 surgeries in your master's degree, then you have performed 50 surgeries between your FSP and KP, then these 50 surgeries won't be counted in your Weiterbildung's surgery.
Okay.
Surgeries. Yeah, so you have to start again from 1 to 500. You have to complete it after your approbation.
Got it. So the goal should be as soon as you have completed your FSP, try to get your KP done as fast as possible so that you can get the permanent license. When you are on a temporary license, you get temporary license for 2 years, and it is must then to clear KP, the cantonese profung, in those 2 years.
Yeah, it is a must. Otherwise, there's no possibility to get your visa extended.
Wow. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you so much for coming on my channel and sharing your knowledge.
Yeah,
I hope that this has helped you, and we have contributed some to your knowledge pool. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button. Also, sharing this video within your community of doctors will help you and create the awareness about this topic. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.